Students, in this lecture we'll discuss about reciprocal theorems in structural analysis. So there are majorly two important reciprocal theorems in structural analysis, that is Maxwell's theorem of reciprocal deflection and second one is Betti's theorem of reciprocal work. So let's see what is Maxwell's theorem states. Okay, so according to Maxwell's theorem, in a linear structure, if load F applied at point 1 causes a deflection D at point 2, then the same force if applied at point 2 will cause the same deflection D at 1. So this means this is just a reverse condition. Okay, so this theorem is valid only for a linear elastic structure. Clear? So if a load affecting at point 1 causes a displacement D at point 2, then the same displacement D will be caused at point 1 if the same load acts at point 2. So other variations of Maxwell's theorem are shown here. There are three variations of Maxwell's theorem are shown here. So first one is the deflection at B due to force, unit force applied at A. So delta VA should be equal to deflection at A due to unit load applied at B. So this is the first variation. This is similar to previous one. Only thing is we replace it with a unit load. The second variation is that the rotation at B due to a unit moment applied at A will be equal to the rotation at A due to unit moment applied at B. Okay, so this is the second variation. And the final variation is that the deflection at B due to a unit rotation applied at A is same as the rotation at A due to unit force applied at B. Okay. So now let's see what is Betti's theorem. So actually Betti's theorem is more generalized version of Maxwell's theorem, and it can be seen that we can derive our previous Maxwell theorem from the Betti's theorem. So Betti's theorem is slightly modernized version. Okay, so this is based on external work. So Betti's theorem states that the total external work done by forces in system 1 and the corresponding displacement in system 2 is equal to the total external work done by forces in system 2 and the corresponding displacement in system 1 in a linear elastic zone. So it has to be understood that external work is nothing but force into corresponding displacement. But here we'll take forces in one system and multiply that with the corresponding displacement in the other system, second system. This should be equal to the forces in the other system multiplied with the displacements, corresponding displacement of the first system. Okay, so let's see an example. So let's take a beam and apply force F1 at point 1. This will cause a displacement at 1, d delta 11 at 1 and delta 21 at 2. Okay, again we'll apply another force F2 at point 2. Okay, so this F2 will cause a displacement of delta 12 at 1 and delta 22 at 2. Okay, so if you add both of this, it's a together, it's a system, and you can see what is the total deflection under 1 will be delta 11 plus delta 12, and the total deflection number under F2 will be delta 21 plus delta 22. Okay, so according to Maxwell's theorem, it states that forces in first system, so this is system 1, okay, and this is system 2. So forces in system 1 multiplied by corresponding displacement, so F1 multiplied by corresponding displacement system 2, F1 into delta 12. Okay, this should be equal to forces in system 2 multiplied by F2 multiplied by displacement, corresponding displacement in system 1. So that is F2 into delta 21. So this is the expression of Betti's theorem. And if you note that if you put F1 equal to F2 equal to F, you can find that delta 12 will become equal to delta 21. This is nothing but our Maxwell's theorem. So this is more generalized statement for Betti's theorem. It states that it can be used for a two system having large number of force systems also. Okay. Now let's see an example for verifying the Betti's theorem. So here we have a simply supported beam loaded with a central load P as well as a UDN W. So in your previous semester you would have learned deflections using how to calculate deflection of simply supported beams using Macaulay's method, conjugate methods, etc. So here let's break the system into two, break this big example into two parts. One is where we apply point load P only. So point load P only will cause a deflection of PL cube by 48 EI. Okay, and so this is the system one, and another system is we apply only UDL. So when W is applied, it causes a maximum central deflection of 5WL^4/384 EI. Okay, so now in order to prove Betti's theorem, you have to prove that work done by P on W, sorry, P on displacements of second system is equal to work done by W on displacements of the first system. Okay, so work done by P on displacement of second system will be P into maximum deflection at this point, that is P into 5WL^4/384 EI. Okay, so that will become external work done by system one on displacements of system two is 5PWL^4/384 EI. Okay, and the work done by UDN on displacement caused by system one will be W into area of this displacement. Okay, so we have to come, so we know that maximum displacement due to P load is, so P central load is PL cube by 48 EI, and the variation of displacement along X is can be written as delta X is equal to PL cube by 48 EI into 3LX square by minus 4X cube. Okay, so if you want to compute the area of this, you have to integrate it from 0 to L by 2 and multiply by 2, and each of this area point should be multiplied by W. So if you do that also, you will get the same answer, 5PWL^4/384 EI. So this is the external work done by UDL on the displacements of system one, and this is the external work done by P on the displacement of UDL W. Okay, so in this way, this and this values are same. So we can say that Betti's theorem is validated here. Okay, so that's it for today's lecture. Thank you.